Portanto, nós hoje, portanto, dia 25 de maio de 2015, começamos com a primeira das Distinguished Lecture Series, que a reitoria ou a vice-reitoria da IID resolveu introduzir, em que basicamente, portanto, durante um ano nós vamos dedicar-nos à área estratégica do mar e vamos tentar trazer cá pessoas de renome mundial e que nos ajudem realmente a fazer projetos científicos para que possamos mesmo tentar mudar Portugal, e a Universidade do Porto está realmente empenhada nesse aspecto, portanto, na área estratégica do mar. A lição de hoje do professor John Delaney, ele é uma pessoa muito importante a nível e com uma parte política, digamos assim, importante também na política dos Estados Unidos e portanto também do mundo, digamos assim, e veio cá para nos falar do projeto dele, que é absolutamente espantoso.
It's my belief that the power of many different kinds of technologies that are coming to maturity in a similar time frame will allow us to instrument entire volumes of the ocean in ways we've never been able to do before. And when we start doing that type of thing, we're going to discover relationships that we didn't know about before. For example, if you're present in the middle of an erupting underwater volcano, which nobody's ever done before, you're bound to make some discoveries. Having optical ways and acoustic ways, using sound waves, and having chemical approaches, and having ways in which we can look at all sorts of parts of this system, including genomic analysis simultaneously, will allow us to begin defining the nature of marine ecosystems. And marine ecosystems are so complicated that you can't study them very well with only one or two sensors and one ship at one time in one place. You have to be in many places all at once measuring many things. That's why I'm so excited about the convergence of multiple different technologies at the same time. That's why. I don't know if I'm wise enough to judge the A path for Portugal, but I can say that the history of Portugal and the current capabilities that exist in Portugal are such that I believe there's a huge opportunity to become involved in understanding large portions of the ocean. And unlike any other country that I'm aware of, Portugal, for the size of its land area, is responsible for a huge portion of the ocean. And that puts them in a position that is slightly analogous to what Henry the Navigator first started doing, which was just exploring. But what's different now is you're not exploring places to go, you're exploring the changes that take place in the ocean. You're effectively exploring the time domain, because we know what the spatial domain is. So we're looking at how ecosystems evolve through time. And that requires the robots, that requires the communication, that requires all sorts of new approaches. And I think Portugal can play in that game very seriously with the right partners, with the right funding, with the right commitment by government, with the right involvement by industry. Why not? What I see as I come and visit, some unbelievably bright people here. You know, it just is a matter of will and a matter of commitment and a matter of all those bright young people that were sitting there not talking, you know, they can become part of the future, and I believe they will. I believe they will. I know of no nation that has the of similar size that has comparable potential, partly because of the amount of ocean that you oversee and you're responsible for, and partly because of the historical tradition and the current capacities that you have for robotics in the marine world. But there'll have to be some tough decisions made by people who have access to funding. And those are called politicians, I think.
Politicians, yeah.
So I don't, that's beyond my expertise. So.